What's going on, gamers? Today, we're going to be going over how to install mods on your Conan Exiles Apex server. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every new tutorial we post, just like this one. Do you enjoy playing Conan Exiles, but feel something extra is needed to spice up the gameplay? Look no further, as Conan Exiles has a Steam Workshop, meaning there's tons of mods made by awesome, talented, and creative creators. Trying to add mods can be pretty difficult sometimes, but with Apex Hosting, adding mods for a Conan Exiles server is simple, and today we're going to show you just how to do it. Finding and downloading mods is pretty easy for Conan Exiles. We're going to start you off with subscribing to a mod through the Steam Workshop. You can find this by clicking on Library, and then clicking on Conan, and then clicking on Workshop. In the Steam Workshop, you can sort by most popular to get a look at the coolest and most updated mods. Be careful when you're looking for mods so you don't get outdated ones. Now you just need to find your mod, click on it, check if it's updated, and then click on subscribe. For this example, we're using three different mods, but you can do the same if you're uploading a different amount or even just one mod. So once you've got it downloaded and it's fully installed onto your Conan Exiles, go ahead and click on Library again and click on Conan. Then right-click Conan on the list and hover over Manage, and then click on Browse Local Files until a window opens. At the top of the file manager, go ahead and click on the Steam Apps folder. Then click on Workshop, and then click into Content. And finally, click into the folder named 440900. Here, there's going to be a folder with numbers representing each mod. The pack files inside are the important mod files. These need to be zipped for easy uploading. Once they are zipped inside the folder, you can move them to a place you can easily access, like your desktop or a folder just for this purpose. You're going to want to have every zip file in the same location unless you want to sort through finding them in every folder for the upload. Here, I'm just moving them to the root folder, somewhere I can remember easy. Once we've got the folders all in the same place, you're ready to begin uploading the mod files. Uploading your files is pretty easy. Go ahead and hop into your Apex server panel and then stop your server. And once your server goes from online to offline, go ahead and click on FTP file access on the left-hand side of the page. Now just log in with your information. And once you're in the folder explorer, go ahead and navigate to the Conan Sandbox folder and click into it. And if you don't have a mods folder here, which you should, you can just make one. It's pretty easy to do. And then you're going to need to click into the mods folder once it is made. Once you're in here, go ahead and click on upload to the top left of the page. Here, you're going to go to a page where you could just click on the folder that you downloaded your zipped pack files to and bring those up. And now all you need to do is click and drag them over to the right side of the page where it says drop files here to upload. If you find that it's taking too long, we have a guide linked in the description below this video, of course, on how to upload your files to an FTP program like FileZilla or CyberDuck. Now that you've got all of your files uploaded to the server, all you need to do is click on back and then check the boxes next to each of the zip files. Once you've checked those boxes, click on Unzipped at the top right. And once you click on Unzip, it will take you here where it'll prompt you to stop your server, which you don't need to do because your server should be stopped by now. And then click on Submit. You should get three Done, Returned, OK messages. And that's how you know that you have successfully uploaded and unzipped these files. Now all you need to do is head back, so that we can configure the text files for your server. Next to your modlist.txt file is going to be an edit button. Click on the edit button, and inside, you're going to type in the file accurate names to the pack files. An easy way to get these names by copying and pasting, of course, is going to be heading back into those folders and simply renaming and then copying the names. Now you can head back to the modlist.txt file and paste them in one by one, or just paste in the one name if you only have one file. Before you paste in the name, it's a good idea to also add in an asterisk, but you can just paste it in and then add the asterisk to the beginning of the name. In all of your files in this text file should have an asterisk and then the file accurate name of the file. Once you've got those in there, all you need to do is click on save. And once you've clicked on save, you can click on the name of your server at the top of the page and either start or restart your server to get it up and running with mods. Here at Apex Hosting, we know that mods are probably the best part of owning and operating a server, playing outside of the limits of your favorite games. That's why we try and make uploading mods to any server type easy. Well, folks, we hope you found this tutorial useful, and as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.